the love of my life, and I hope that someone can take something away from that, because so basically that says that most of the things that I'm going to show you will be skin cases, because it's visual. I can't tell you how I can't show you the cases where I've treated pancreatitis or pyometra or other things like that, because they're not visual. So, and my surgery at the Sunshine Coast is called the Natural Vets, and we treat pretty much everything without drugs. I might use some antibiotics, but maybe once or twice a year, and that would be only driven by a client in some panic. As far as I'm concerned, they're never going to really add strength. I may use an anti-inflammatory, but it might usually be a herbal thing so that it doesn't knock the animal around. I'd only be using something to add strength. I've used the term here, Newtonian medicine, and I guess that by that I mean like things we can see, and we use a drug that has a certain effect to counteract something that we can see with our eyes. And that system is, well, it's pretty much self-explanatory. It's a system that's easily corrupted by the pharmaceutical companies wanting everyone to use their drug to do that. I'm not really treating with that type of system, and I guess the first thing to understand is that we're not actually physical. Everyone's gone. Well,
no, are you talking?
maybe I'll wait till the girls come back, hey? I probably should, yeah. Maybe I was like, no, I'll be boring.
No.
This is
interesting, because I do write here as well, so and there's more to us than just the body.
Yeah, so you know, you have to understand that as a base point, that we are not just the physical body, but there's part of something that is a vital force, a vital healing force that's within us. And although we might all understand that there's things that aren't explained by science, to actually go and use that energy or life force or vitality to cure is not what we're taught at school. So this is really important, that my assumption when an animal comes in is that it is smarter than any scientist, smarter than anything that I could possibly ever know. The healing mechanism that's in that and in each of us is with microscopes and things, we're only ever going to be looking at external stuff. It's a whole being here, and that being produces a symptom in an attempt to keep itself well and healthy, and that symptom is not to be stopped. It's a very important thing. It's what we're given to do the healing on, but really it's a whole whale under the surface, and we're only looking at the fin that's up, and we have to treat that with honour and not just make it go away with an anti this or an anti that. It has to be helped, and that is where observation is most important for the work that I do, is mostly observing what is this animal trying to do so that I can honour that and help it do that. Interspersed during my theory stuff is cases, and you can see this is a cat that's got a pretty nasty dermatitis, moist dermatitis, and this was sort of all weepy here, and this is wet as well. You can see the thickening that's on there where the cat has licked into hyperpigmented areas as black thickened skin, and it stunk, and it was a pretty awful cat as well. Like, the owners didn't really like it. It was not a likable being. It was a cat that was withdrawn and mean. If they went to do stuff with it, it would scratch them. And it wasn't due to this. That was just the end result of that. This is after I began to treat it. You can see that initially some of that inflammation is backed off. And that's it after a little bit of treatment. That was about 3 months down the track with no antibiotics, no anti-inflammatories, no drugs of any sort. And but the important thing about the case is that from being a mean, nasty critter, it became really nice. The people loved the cat after that. It just to sit on their knee. They cherished it and went on to live another 5 years, died at 17 years old. This was the thing that when I first came out, there was only antibiotics and anti-inflammatories or mixtures of the two. And so in some ways, life was simple, an animal would come in, you'd look at where the pus was coming from and you'd give it an antibiotic, and you had a choice of 10 different antibiotics and give that to kill the germs. And if there was pain, you'd give a choice of a few different anti-inflammatories to take the pain out. But there was no search for cure or why the pus was pouring out or why the inflammation was there. It was only, let's get rid of the symptom, not treat the whale, not fix the animal. And this leads, of course, to the situation that happens in modern practice where an animal comes in with a bad ear or a bad leg, and we use an anti-inflammatory and an antibiotic, and the antibiotic will fix the ear. It will make the ear symptom go away. But as soon as that animal strengthens up and has digested the antibiotic, the strength is still there, it will pour out again and make the ear discharge again, and we treat it again. And that will happen year in, year out. In the practice that I am, people come to me after many years of that suppression of the immune system, and as I take history, I see that ear things will often be suppressed each month for a long, long time with a different antibiotic, a different anti-inflammatory, and often both combined in an ointment. And eventually, the body's eventually throws its hands up and won't make an ear infection anymore. Sometimes the system will then change and become deeper and begin to cause liver problems or kidney problems or gut problems as the system has just been out of whack and had to try and repair on a deeper level. This is our mate Einstein. And him saying that we'll require substantially new manner of thinking if humankind is to survive. And, I guess the medicine that I use, I regard as being a medicine that can help solve most of the world's troubles and save most of, even things like originally in Europe when they had malaria, they found that the bark of the China tree could help from South America, and they decimated that Peruvian rainforest to get the Peruvian bark to take to Europe to cure the malaria cases. And the medicine that I have is we can make enough medicine from one Peruvian bark tree to treat the whole world. So true healing is done by the body's own healing forces, and it knows exactly what to do. And the most perfect medical system should see what the body is trying to do and help it do that. And this will be different for each type of animal. So if I see 100 animals with a discharge of yellow pus from the left ear, I will perhaps use 50 different remedies to treat that. So it's not a matter of just giving an antibiotic and an anti-inflammatory. My work is really, really, really complex. So each animal I have to work out exactly what it is that goes with the weeping ear. So if they had a yellow discharge from the left ear, I would use a different remedy in a mean, angry, axe-murdering dog to a soft, soupy, lovely little dog. And so I have to match not just the ear, but I have to match the whole system to get a cure. Otherwise, you're not going to get anywhere. You're just going to end up suppressing, or you're just going to work for a little while.